Good morning, children. Hope you are doing well. Today we'll deal the class 514 assignment from the lesson called nervous system. Let's see. Given below is the picture of a human brain and label and color the different parts of the brain and describe its function. So here the parts we have to identify. The first part is cerebrum. The first part is cerebrum, that you all know this is the largest part of the brain. Second part is cerebellum. And the third part is brainstem. Children, color these all parts. Hope you will enjoy by coloring these all. Next, let's see this function of the these particular parts of the brain. The first part is cerebrum. It controls our voluntary muscles. And the second point is it helps us to see, hear, think, and remember. So not only this, it is also very helpful in solving maths problems or running in the field also. And the one more important point of the cerebrum is it controls all the feelings, such as like sadness and fear. Okay, these are also some important functions of the cerebrum. Let's go with the cerebellum. It is responsible for our posture. Now I am standing. This is called posture. Our posture, balance. See, I stand here. So this is nothing but balance. Next, movement, and coordination of muscles. I am writing here. So this will happen only when the coordination of muscles is appear. So every action is itself an important one. Next, helps it, and one more important function, helps us stand straight, without losing our balance, These are the important functions of the cerebellum. Next, the third part is called brainstem. Let's see these functions of brainstems also. It controls. As here cerebrum mentions voluntary muscles, but here the brainstem controls our involuntary muscles. And also responsible for such actions called and responsible for actions responsible for actions such as breathing, blood circulation, coughing, and sneezing. Okay, These are very, very important functions of the brain. Next. So the second bit. See this. Complete the reflex action with the suitable words given in the clue box. The what is this? See, stimulus, example heat, receptor, organ is skin, and here some blanks are given. We have to fill this, and the effector organ is there, muscles, response. What is this example? Withdrawal of the hand. So before understanding, actually this is an example. Before understanding this example, we have to know that reflex action. We have to know the reflex action. Reflex actions are nothing but which done automatically without our knowledge. It happens automatically. So this is nothing but reflex action. Reflex action. This reflex actions are completely controlled under spinal cord. Controlled under spinal cord. The spinal cord is an important, playing actually a major role in the reflex action. So that reflex action can be explained to you by giving this example. Okay, let's see that. For example, if you touch a heat object, for example, milk, hot milk, anything you can take. So if you touch that particular object, what happened? Immediately you feel the pain, right? So as you touch that object, immediately this information from the sensory nerves to pass this information through the sensory nerves to spinal cord. So immediately what spinal cord will do? The spinal cord will give the order to the motor nerves. Will give the order to the motor nerves to take, that means pull away that particular object. By which object I have touched that hand? So pull away the, away from that particular object, that hand, okay. So this information, this order has given by the spinal cord to the motor nerves. So immediately we withdraw our hand. So we touch the heat container, is called stimulus. We get back our hand, is nothing but the response which is given to the stimulus. Now see, so stimulus, we touch the heat ball. And what happened? As we touch, the skin has a sensory nerve. This sensory nerves gives an information to the spinal cord. This spinal cord give an order to motor nerves to that particular organ, that which organ I have used hand. So that organ to withdraw immediately from the our hand. So this will happen automatically without feel the pain even. So not only this, but two or more examples also we can give, that is blinking of hands, blinking of eyes, and nothing. And one more example, that when we see the tasty food, mouth watering of mouth. Okay, these are the examples. Okay, so this is a very, very interesting topic. So please you selfly assume and give some more examples also. So please keep the discussion with your teacher, and thank you so much.